Okay, hey everyone. A little under the weather, so sorry if that is reflected in my voice. We're gonna make one of these spreadsheet-driven recap files. I hope this video is helpful to anyone who is still on the fence about how this works. And I think what we're gonna do is this is not the file I want to open. I think what I want to make is a jig for manufacturing these end caps here. So I'll get started on that. Let me not get too far ahead of myself. It's just, and I haven't done this. It's not like I have a file that I'm going to be referring to. I'm actually doing this as I go. So I started a new file here. And I think the first thing I'm going to do is create a spreadsheet. So open up the spreadsheet workbench. And click new spreadsheet, and I'm going to rename it by pressing the F2 key. And then dimensions. And let's populate some of these dimensions. So I'm going to steal the columns. Ooh, I don't know if I can copy these. Let's try Control C, Control V. No, okay, it doesn't work. So I guess I have main input, output, and that. Bold and underline that. So what we're gonna do is a lot of these are gonna be the same as what's on the spreadsheet for the cylinder building. Like probably cap length. Because we need to know what the hole centers are with these four holes. And those hole centers are actually given by
if you have to go
Yeah, so anyway, it looks like these hole centers are given by the they're the same as the outer radius of the cylinder. Okay. So interesting. So anyway, we can start with that. So rod spacing, cap width. Oh, you know what? Make that one word. And these what's in these columns don't really matter. It's gonna be the alias of these columns that matter. But I like to make it consistent. Well, not really. Look at my path trip. But it'd be good here just to keep it consistent. For the sake of learning, what other parameters are going to matter? I guess the rod size is going to matter because we need a jig that can be bored into that amount. So the rod diameter. Forget that whole thing about keeping these consistent with the areas. Because I explore the radius instead of the diameter. And then for manufacturing this, we also need to know I think that's about it. We honestly don't even really need to know the width. We just need to know the tie rod spacing. Okay, so I may be wrong, but at this point I think that these are really the only ones that we need. So let's just input a value for the tie rod spacing. And you know what I can do here is put a parentheses cylinder. What do we do? Tie rod spacing is equal to cylinder. OD in cylinder builder dot. Okay. And our value we'll just do 1 for now. And our output is going to be equals B2 times 25.4 millimeters. And we'll probably actually divide that by 2, because we don't need units. And the reason being is that if you go and look at this spreadsheet or this sketch. You can actually see that I'm using a center point distance, whereas the spacing here is actually equal to the diameter. The center point distance is equal to the radius. So we're going to have to really divide by 2 in there behind the scenes. So that when you go to enter this, you're saying, no, well, the holes are 4-inch centers, or, you know, instead of a midpoint distance. Okay, cap width. You know what we can do here? We'll just give ourselves a note that says, calculated as tie rod spacing times 1.5, just to give ourselves enough meat. And then rod diameter. What is our rod diameter on this? Happy. The 2.5-inch rod. That's good enough for this. And we're going to do a similar thing where we scale that down, because what we care about are radii, not diameters. Why not just keep putting millimeters in when we really don't need to? Okay, cap width. is going to equal b 2 times 1.5, and this will equal b 3 times 25.4. Once again, you can see that on my version of this program, this automatically changes, and that may be because I really don't know why that is. I don't care to speculate. Okay, so we've got a few dimensions in. Now let's give ourselves some aliases. And we'll call the first one tie rod spacing. We'll call the second one width, and we'll call the third one rod rad radius. Okay, so let's save our document. I'll just go to my desktop. This is going to be a fixture. I tried to make this video a few months ago. And there's a document floating around somewhere, but I just figured I'd start from fresh. So let's get modeling. Let's go to our sketcher workbench. And we will grab. Oh, actually, we'll do part design first. Because we want to put in a new body. So we're going to put in a new body and create a sketch. We'll do the XZ plane, and I guess we'll start by making it's a 50-50 because we can either start with our rod for the lathe or with our with the plate that the rod gets welded to. So let's start with the rod. This will be on center. We're gonna make this diameter a little bit larger than the we're going to make this radius a little bit larger than the radius of the rod. I guess we should do it to the nearest eighth inch. That sounds too tricky. Let's just scale it up from the rod diameter. So equals dimensions dot rod rad times make it slightly larger, 10% larger. Okay. And the name for this is fixture rod radius. So, whoa. Why is that in inches? Usually, maybe I don't have to do this anymore. Okay. You see, it used to be that I had to export in. In millimeters and didn't have to put the unit in. But now I'm having to export in with the units attached. Okay, so just adapt to whatever it throws at you. Okay, so here's our radius of our fixture rod, and we can go ahead and pad this out. So we've got this sketch, and we're going to pad that. And I'm going to do it reversed, so that when I look down, maybe I'll just reverse the other pad. Sorry, I'm thinking ahead. Okay, we're gonna make the length just a standard 6 inches. And that does not need to be parametrized. That's 6 inches, this should be good. You just need a stub of this to grab onto in the lathe. Now we can do another sketch on this face. We'll do a sketch there. So I selected the face and put sketch. And I'm gonna put a little cut, a little pocket into this. And this is gonna be equal to 2 dimensions rod rad. We'll just make that equal 4 pocket. And we can go to our part design workbench and put in a little pocket. And we can go in a quarter inch. Okay, so this is not really what it's gonna look like when you make it. This is just what it'll look like after you've made a fixture on it, because you would drill, you know, an extra whatever half inch or so into this, just so that your boring tool can go all the way through the cap fixture. And let's make that a half inch. Okay, so don't worry about that pocket right now. I'm just showing a little bit of what it'll actually look like in real life. So there's our one body. Let's make another body. We're gonna rename this smooth fixture. Fixture round. And this one will be fixture height. sure that there's better names out there for what I'm doing. Okay, I'm gonna do this sketch on the same plane, XZ plane. And so right now, if you can see, fixture plate is bold, that's active. If I wanted to make this active, I would have to right click toggle active body or just double click it. But this one we want to make our active body because we're working on it. So we'll put a sketch in on this plane. And I'm actually going to go look at it over here. And this is going to be a plate. So we draw a corner rectangle. And we will do, we're going to select these three lines and make them symmetric. Oh, sorry. This point. Oh, how do I do this? I think I got a point. Let's see, I thought it was here. Maybe it's the origin. Two points in a symmetry thing. Okay, so let me grab the point. Let's be my main. Geez, sorry guys, I can't really remember how to do symmetry. It's been a few months. Let me see what I did over here. Three, five. It looks like it's okay, I'm gonna pause the video till I figure this out. Okay, that's weird. I just went right back into the sketch after I paused the video, and now I can grab the points. So I just closed, I guess I just closed the sketch and reopened it. So now I'm grabbing these two points, center, the x-axis line, and I'm doing symmetrical. I'm doing these two points, and I'm doing symmetrical. So now we have a center point. This will be a square, so you can make these equality. And now you have a square. Okay, so yeah, that was weird. I couldn't grab the points at first, but I closed the sketch. And now our only degree of freedom is what is the length of these sides. So I'm going to make the length of these sides from center to here. I'll define that. And that's going to be equal to dimensions dot, what is it, k at width, 6 inches. There we go. Oh, you know what? That's way too big. That's, divided by 2 over here. And what's interesting is that this one is, I don't have the units, and it gave me the right answer. It gave me that 6 inches that I was looking for. And you can see now this has been updated to 3 inches. So, who knows, I had to put units in for this guy, but not this one. Okay. We also want to put those holes in. So I'll start by drawing 4 circles. 1, 2, 3, 4. These have the same symmetry requirements. And these two horizontally constrained, and these two vertically constrained. So the other thing is all of these are going to be equal in size. And the diameter of those holes, if that needs to be put into our spreadsheet. I love diameter. Okay, I hope you're following along with what I'm doing here. So the diameter of this is going to be equal dimensions tie rod rad. Okay. This one's also in inches. But actually, when I exit the sketch and reopen it, it's okay. So maybe I didn't need to put units in there. Okay, so our degrees of freedom are where these are. So we know that it's tie rod spacing. So we can start by doing a distance from the origin. Oh, you know what would be even cooler? I was gonna say if they all fell in the arc of a circle. What if we drew a circle? And there's a way to toggle construction geometry. Yeah, it's this button here. It's that'll be thick. So this is construction geometry right here. And let me say our yeah. Okay, cool. So it's not 4-inch centers, it's they fall on the on a 4-inch circle. So this is going to be equal to those dimensions tie rod spacing. And let's update. Okay, you can just click update sketch. Okay, great. So if I put this one tangential oh, here we go. Fix it onto the object. Yeah. Is that what I want though? That doesn't seem right. Oh, it is right. It's just, we're just dealing with a massive. Yeah, I think that these. So in this, I have tile down there to 1/2 inch. And in this one, I have it 5/8. Oops. I hate when this happens. But typically clicking axiomatic view will take me back. Okay, there we are. So okay, let's just go with this for now. It doesn't look right, but I think it is right. What am I doing here? I'm doing. Okay, that's what I'm doing. They're not falling on a square. They're not falling on a circle. They're falling on the corners of a square, whose side length is the radius. Okay. Well, sorry for misleading you guys. Go back to the sketch. We'll delete this. And yeah, okay, so we're actually going to move these away. I'm going to draw another square. Yeah, that's weird. I had to close and reopen. So, oh, that's what it is. That's funny, the view. Check that out. If I'm looking at it from the front, I can grab the corners. If I'm looking at it from the back, I can't grab the corners. Oh, that's dumb. Okay, alright, well, I'm gonna hit it from the front. And we're gonna do our symmetry. Okay. And we're gonna set this side line. You go to this one and our distance. Hold this. Distance from the origin is going to be equal to time dimensions time spacing. Okay. You go. Now this point is going to be so. Boom, Denskis. Okay, so our model looks good and constrained. And we can go ahead and set, oh, you know what? We gotta set this to construction geometry. There you go. I'm not gonna bother chamfering the edges. Does not need to be done. I mean, obviously in real life you would probably want to. Okay, so we're going to exit sketch. And you can, oh, you know what? There's one more thing. There's the bore. Because we want to do a press fit. So we're gonna do like a 2 or 3 thousandths inch press fit. So we will set this diameter to be equals sketch 01 constraints bore pocket. No. That can't be it. It must be sketch. Fixture rod rad. Yeah, it's gonna be that minus 0.3 thousandths. You go. Now we can add that. Let me show this one. I like that a lot. Let me make it half inch. So there you go, there's your fixture. Now let's see if this thing. Let's see if the parameterization actually works. Let's say we wanted to do 5/8 Bowls. Well, did those get bigger? Let's make it maybe 1/4 inch. Yeah, obviously that's working. Let's make our rod diameter a 3 inch. And our tie rods, let's, yeah, the cylinder outer diameter is like an 8 inch cylinder with 5/8. Wow. I mean, yeah, you're limited on the size cylinder you can make by the swing of your lathe. But, so this is a multi-purpose jig. These holes, and actually, we can do something clever here. We could put in another hole pattern. We could do something clever here, where we put in two hole patterns, one with dowel holes, because the way, okay, so the way you would actually make this, and I have a note about this on my log that I typed up real quick at email to Margin, is you would actually make two of these holes tapped holes and two of them dowel holes so that you can locate yourself. But anyway, I hope this video was helpful. I'm not going to go on very much longer. Not really feeling well. Any questions, feel free to reach out to me.